And now we welcome the couples back onto the floor for Heat 1 in the semi-final in Viennese Waltz. In this semi-final, we have a couple from Slovenia, one couple from Russia, one from Germany, one from Italy, one from Poland, and one couple from Denmark. Couple number 60, Emmanuel Valeri and Tonya Kelly from Denmark. Demonstrating a fleckle in the middle of the floor with a contra check to a natural fleckle. Coming out into a natural turn. Couple number 15, Luca Bosoletti and Sasha Vulic from Slovenia. The characteristic movements permissible within a Viennese waltz are natural turns which rotate to the right, reverse turns which rotate to the left, the change from the natural rotation to the reverse, and the change from the reverse rotation to the natural. You see the characteristic movement of the rotation here being clearly danced by the Slovenian couple. And here we see couple number 29 from Italy bringing us to the end of Heat 1 in the Viennese Waltz. And now it's time for Heat 2. We have a couple from England, a couple from Italy, one couple from Russia, one couple from Poland, one couple from Germany, and one couple from Lithuania. Couple number 16 from England, dancing a natural fleckle to a natural turn. Couple number 61 from Lithuania, Donatas Vitsielis and Lina Chatkevičiūtė. Couple number 52 from Germany. You can see clearly how the man swings into position to create the rotation around the lady. Being demonstrated here very clearly by couple number 19 from Italy. Number 34 from Poland, Victor Kitska and Malgorzata Galicka. And that, ladies and gentlemen, brings us to the end of Heat 2 and the end of Viennese Waltz in the European semi-finals in standard.
I think that every single dance competition, also if it's not a championship, is important just to make you your trip in the world of dance, dancing better, develop and getting the best dancer in the world.
Expectation is always to dance well first in the beginning, and then it depends also on the judges, so it's normally in the hands. But
we can try to make the hard work for the other one. I mean, I think the winner is already there, but we can try.
The podium wouldn't be bad.
Yeah, the podium will be a nice goal.
And now it's Heat 1 in the semi-finals in slow foxtrot. We have two couples from Poland, one couple from Slovenia, one couple from Italy, one couple from Russia, and one couple from Germany. Starting us off is couple number 52 from Germany. Couple number 19 from Italy, Federico Di Toro and Geni Favero. Slow foxtrot in its basic character is a dance that is very lineal, and you can see this here being danced by this Italian couple. You can also see the clarity of the rolling action of the feet across the floor. Couple number 37, Marek Kosaty and Paulina Gracik from Poland. You can see the rolling action of the couple across the floor created by the use of the feet and the ankle tension. You see the couple from Slovenia, Luca Bosoletti and Sasha Vulic, couple number 15. This time there'll be some water sharing. Couple number 19, again from Italy. I know what's in store. Now there's a little small lake And ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of Heat 1 in the Slow Foxtrot. And now it's time for Heat 2. We have a couple from England, one couple from Russia, one couple from Germany, one from Italy, one from Denmark, and one from Lithuania. Couple number 29 from Italy, Valerio Colantoni and Sara Di Vaira. Couple number 25 from Germany, Benedetto Ferrugia and Claudia Curler. And the one for me, two tickets west. You can see how the lady's body breathes into the different shapes and positions as she's led to dance the figure by the gentleman. We're gonna be two tickets west. The contrasting body positions which are danced for the couple can be seen clearly here being performed by couple number 25. Closed positions, outside partner positions, promenade positions, all clearly demonstrated, and the judges will be looking for the couples that not only can dance the positions but also show the clarity and ease of change in position. All of my dreams. Here we see couple number 60 from Denmark. Couple number 16 from England. And couple number 61 brings us to the end of the Slow Foxtrot Heat 2 in the European semi-finals. And ladies and gentlemen, now it's time for Heat 1 in the last dance in tonight's semi-final, and it's the quick step. We have two couples from Russia, one couple from Italy, one couple from Germany, one couple from Denmark, and one couple from Lithuania. And here we see couple number 61 from Lithuania, Donatas Vitsielis and Lina Chatkevičiūtė. You'll notice that it's important that the couples maintain the energy level in this dance, not just because of the performance of the character and the technique, but also to show the judges that they have the stamina to be in the final and to be able to present maximum when they come there. You can see the clarity of the footwork and the ankle tension being used here by couple number 30, Marit Gimayev and Elena Bashuk from Russia. Couple number 60, Emmanuel Valeri and Tonya Kelly from Denmark. And here we see a scatter chasse, which is a typical action used in a quick step, being danced by couple number 30 from Russia. And ladies and gentlemen, that's the end of Heat 1 in the quick step. And now it's time for Heat 2 in this last dance in the semi-final, quick step. And here we see couple number 34 from Poland, Victor Kitska and Małgorzata Garlicka. You'll notice the direction they move around the floor, which is an anti-clockwise direction. This is referred to in dancing as the line of dance. It's important that all couples follow this directional movement at all times. Couple number 15 from Slovenia can be seen here dancing rotational movements in place with a bouncing action created from ankle tension. That's classical of one of the actions used in quick step. Couple number 37 from Poland, Marek Kosaty and Paulina Glatzik. Ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of Heat 2 in Quick Step and to the end of the semi-final in the European Standard Championships from Mégève in France. We'll see you again in a short while when we go into the finals.
With the semi-finals over, and before we move on to the final, let's acquaint ourselves with one of the top couples here. Former 10 Dance World Champions who came fourth at last year's World Championship in Standard Dancing, Marat Gimayev and Alina Bashyuk from Russia, who've danced together for nearly a decade now. This dancing history has certainly made them strong competitors. We asked them how this successful union came about.
I split with my previous partner, and I was searching for a new girl. At that time, my main coach, who is our main coach now, Alexander Melnikov, he offered me, why don't you try out with Alina? I said, of course, why not?
Actually, first I refused because just a year ago I started to dance with another partner, so we had a very good, I think, dancing relationship, and I was pleased with everything. So first, when Marat called me, I said, no, I'm not actually planning to change anything. And then our coach called me and said, well, girl, you know, you have to think.
The couple started dancing at an early age, and a good understanding contributed to a strong dancing partnership. But what sets this couple apart from the rest?
What makes us strong? We are perfectionists, so it will not be valuable for us if we've got all the honors in the world, but we're not satisfied with our dancing. We really want to dance very good and to enjoy ourselves, our dancing, and to make people enjoy it. So I think this is what drives us forward.
To perform at this top level, raw talent is not everything. Tough training and dedication to dance is key. And to stay on top, sacrifices have to be made along the way.
We did a Latin section for quite a long time. So we were trying to develop both disciplines in the very same way. So one day we practiced ballroom, another Latin, and eventually it brought us to become world champions in ten dance, in the combination. We really liked doing Latin. I remember it was very, very big fun. Unfortunately, it's not really possible to continue doing both with the demands of the competition. So you have to be really, really on your top form in either one section.
Marat and Alina spend most of the year traveling around the globe competing. And with continuous training and new floor experiences, good results do follow. But out of all of their achievements, which one does this pairing treasure the most?
On every stage, of course, you know, everything is very dear and valuable to you, but what I will never forget is when we first time we made the final at Blackpool. It's a very big dance festival, so it was, I don't think that we, of course we aimed for it, but I don't think that we expected it to happen that year, and it did happen, and it was just unforgettable.
Our future plans are very simple: to become number one, and to become number one in a way that we deserve it, in a way that we stand there strongly on that position. Because of course it's very nice to be a good dancer, to enjoy your dancing, but at the same time we could easily go to a disco, you know, with that approach. So there are two sides of the medal here. And having said that, we are very focused on being self-expressive and emotional and enjoying, we still want to have this title, and we'll definitely do it.
Currently ranked second in the world, it was no surprise to find the couple among the seven pairings who are about to contest the final.